Filming attempt number two. Hello and welcome to the Freakish Lemon video podcast. I am your host, the Freakish Lemon. I go by Adrian and I use masculine pronouns. Welcome back, any returning viewers, and welcome any new viewers to my little podcast. This is a crafty type podcast coming to you from the northwest hills of Connecticut. Show notes for this episode and all other episodes can be found at my website at freakishlemon.com. We do have a Ravelry group. If you search Freakish Lemon in the Groups tab, you will find us. You can follow me at all the fun places like Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, Ravelry, Etsy, and all the links to all those things will be in the down bar below. And please remember to subscribe by clicking the little subscribe button over here if you want to be notified when I have new episodes out. I had some technical difficulties when I tried this the first time yesterday, so we're trying it again. And you can kind of see a little bit of her head. Pen, pick your head up. Pick your head up. Oh, there's a little bit of her head. I have a co-host today. She wants to be on my lap, so we'll see how long this lasts. Had the door closed for table prep, and she was just whining and whining, and then she sat under the table and waited for me to pick her up, so. Spoiled little baby's gonna be up here for a little while. So, some quick life stuff, hopefully quick. It was not so quick in my first recording. We'll try to cut it a little bit. I did put out a video last week, a shorter video, 13 non-traditional Halloween movies, which people seem to like a lot. I was planning on doing a second one, and I in fact mentioned a second one in that video, but it did not happen. I filmed it, it wasn't good, and then I ran out of time, so not happening. It was about free Halloween stuff, movies, audio, books. Free stuff you can get, so I will put all my notes, I'll clean up my notes and put those notes down in the down bar and in the show notes so you guys can go see some free Halloween movies and listen to some free Halloween audio stuff and read some free Halloweeny books. Last week I was on vacation, which was wonderful, and which is why I might be tired and ridiculous during this filming, because I'm filming this Tuesday, October 18th, because my weekend got eaten. Yes, Penny. Which I'll talk about in a minute. So I did a lot of knitting, and I did a lot of spinning, and I did a lot of sewing, but most of the sewing I can't actually show you because it's Halloween costume stuff. I like to take a week off in October to do Halloween costume stuff, especially if I'm doing a new costume that year, instead of just touching up an old one. New costume this year, but I'm not telling you until it's Halloweeny time. Yes, I'm not. You have a new costume this year too, because we go together this year. So yeah, that was really nice to be on vacation. And my weekend got eaten up this past weekend, because this past weekend was the New York Sheep and Wool Festival out in Rhinebeck, New York. Rhinebeck, New York is about an hour and 40-ish minutes from where I live, so that's a quick trip down the road. Sometimes it takes me longer to get to work, depending on how terrible it is between here and Hartford. So, that's a really bad day if it takes me an hour and 40 minutes to get to work. But where are you trying to go, Pen? Are you trying to go on the table? There's no room for you on the table. And you've smelled everything up here. So I don't know what you're looking for. What was I saying? Yes. Rhinebeck, New York. Not that far from where I live. So we opted to go both days this year and just drive to and from. And, where are you trying to go? distracted by the dog. So we drove up there, and Saturday was the podcaster meetup, which last year was overwhelming because it was the first time I was meeting anyone. This year it was overwhelming because people actually knew who I was, which is bizarre. Because I'm freaking small potatoes. When it comes to podcasting, I'm nobody. But it was really cool to meet some viewers and meet up with some of the New York knit nerds who I've hung out with before, and meet some other podcast friends for the first time. And meet up with Allie and Melissa, who we had hung out with during Stitches Midwest all weekend. So it was really fun, really overwhelming. We just kind of wandered around like in a daze for a couple more hours after the meetup kind of dispersed. And Pen, you're slipping right off my lap. Ooh, there we go. Yeah, so we were wandering around in a daze, just kind of overwhelmed and worn out, because there's not really any good spots to just go sit and be quiet at Rhinebeck, unless you want to go sit in the parking lot, I would imagine. But, okay, Pen, now this paw is digging into my leg. You gotta shift this paw just a smidge. Where is it? There we go. Oh, sorry. Yeah. But it was really fun, and it was nice to see everybody. We did a teeny bit of shopping on Saturday. Yes, we did, Pen. Hi. And then we went back Sunday. Oh, didn't even tell you who I went with. It was me and Gabby, my sister, who hosts the Once Upon a Corgi podcast. The two of us went Saturday. And then on Sunday, my mom joined us, and Gabby's friend Danielle joined us. So we drove up. We did our shopping then. Where are you trying to go? Do you want to get down? Because you're slipping now. You want to get down? Or you want to stay up here? You want to stay up here? Okay. Yeah. Yesterday I was super loopy. Today I have a dog in my lap. I don't know what I'm saying. But we did our shopping on Sunday, and we walked around. We made good time, and we got some cool stuff, and we had a few extra minutes with some other podcast people who we didn't really get to talk to on Saturday because they were mobbed. And this dog is seriously sliding right off my lap. I don't think you're going to stay up here for much longer, Pen. Oh, poor baby. And it was a good time. It was very exhausting, though. Luckily, I drove on Saturday. I don't know if I would have been able to drive Sunday. But the excitement of going up there meant I was alert for driving. And then the adrenaline... Yes? The adrenaline... Excuse me. The adrenaline afterwards kept me going on our way home. What are you barking at? There's nothing over here. What? Do you want to get down? What is this move? She's got her head under the table and her butt in my elbow. I think she needs to get down now. Go ahead, go on the bed. That's what she really wanted. She wanted to look out the window. Yeah, but it was a beautiful drive. There are no major highways between my house and Rhinebeck, New York, so it's all back roads, and this is a great time of year to be driving along New England back roads, because all the leaves are lovely, and there's some really great, photo spots on the way to and from. So yeah, it was a great, great time. Got to meet a lot of people, and it was exciting. And stressful, but exciting. So yeah, that was Rhinebeck. It's a bit of a blur, to be frank. Just a quick couple of other things for life stuff. This morning, actually, I posted a snippet of a Star Wars time travel fic on Tumblr, people seem to really like it, so if you're interested in Star Wars time travel, I'll leave a link in the show notes. It's not like a full fic, it's like a chapter, but you know, if you're interested, I'll put a link in the show notes. I have dog hair all over my entire self now. And last thing that I'm going to put here is I'd like to do a giveaway. The Ravelry group is nearing 150 members. There was 143 last time I looked. So as soon as that number goes up to 150, I'm going to put a thread in the group. And I'm going to give away this alpaca yarn and hat pattern that I got at Knit and Pearls in Avon during the yarn crawl. I figured this would be a good Christmas present if somebody just needs something to make for somebody real quick, or make for yourself as winter's approaching. So I'm going to put that up as a giveaway for 150 group members. If we hit 150 by Halloween, which I hope we do, because seven people isn't that many. That didn't sound right for a second there. So, you know, if you haven't joined the group, please do. And if we hit 150 by the next episode, which would be like the around Halloween, probably the 1st or 2nd of November, then the following two, the episode after that, I will pull for the giveaway. So let's move on to knitting stuff, because that was a lot of talking just there. Less than yesterday, I think, but still a lot. I have two finished objects this week. The first is, I'm very impressed with myself, my Rhinebeck sweater. This is the Redford sweater by Julie Hoover in Yarn Place Basic Fingering Wool in a gray color. There's this kind of collar detail. There are these reverse stockinette side panels. It is a seamed sweater. I knit it on US 1 2.25 millimeter needles, and it fits, which is really, I find really impressive for my first sweater. I was pretty sure it was going to be a horror story, but it wasn't. This could be a little bit looser. I think that's just the bind off. Ideally, I would have maybe an inch, maybe 2 inches more positive ease just in the body. But the length of the sleeves is perfect. The actual length of the shirt is perfect. I thought it was going to be way too long, but I forgot that there's no ribbing on the waistband type area. I don't know what you call this area of the sweater. So I thought it was going to be too long, but this actually falls in on me like just about the bottom edge of a belt if I was to wear a belt. It hits just below there, which it never does for shirts for me because I have wide shoulders and a short torso. So yeah, I'm very pleased with how this turned out. I would probably go up a size if I was to make this again, just for the extra roominess, because I do like things to be just a little bit more roomy, especially like long sleeve shirts. But I'm very pleased with it. And now I've been bitten by the sweater bug. Now I want to make sweaters. My next sweater will probably be a cabled sweater because the miles of stockinette on this was really, really boring after a while. And it got to crunch time, so I couldn't really, I mean, I could have worked on other things, but I wanted to have the sweater done for Rhinebeck, so I wasn't working on other things. But I might make this again sometime. I would not necessarily recommend it as a first sweater because it's hard to get a frame of reference for the size because of those side panels, because they're knit separate, so the front and the back are not going to fit you around. But it was good. And I also finished, shaking the table, my Descent shawl, which is a pattern by Lisa Much. Now, the shape of my shawl is not quite the same shape as her shawl, because you can tell I kind of did the right number of increases through here, and then I forgot to do the right number of increases. So I did probably half as many increases for a huge chunk of the shawl, and then I remembered that I was supposed to do other increases, and it curls back up again. So it's kind of a funny shaped descent shawl. But when you're wearing it, it doesn't really matter that much, because I'm a kerchief style shawl wearer, so it's on like this. This is out of Once Upon a Corgi Yarns in the... This orange is the zombie kangaroo, and this green and purple is Nia. And these are in the Audrey base, which is the 8020 BFL nylon base. I used a US 5, 3.75 millimeter needle. And I really enjoyed it, and I really enjoyed how Lisa Much wrote this pattern. I have some more patterns by her in my queue, and I'm really looking forward to making them now. I'm just going to leave this on for now, instead of futzing with it. So, next are some whips. I have two knitting whips I've been working on. Nope, this is the wrong thing. My notes are in order. I've been working on my Happy Halloween socks, which are in this Halloween quilted bag that I made. These are being done with a Gale's Art sock blank. This is the Pebbles sock pattern by Mina Phillip of the Knitting Expat podcast. And either I have an extra half of a round in one of these socks, or my yarn was tensioned very differently between these two heels, because my double knit sock blank has this extra loop of slack on one side. Oh well. It won't be a problem. It's just a little bit annoying when one side gets twisted up and there's that extra slack all kind of curled around the other edge. Edge? Strand. Words are hard and I'm tired. So these are going well. I'm hoping to have these done by the end of the week. As these are my work knitting, I might be able to finish them soon. Which might bring my total of socks knit this year to 12, for Kristen of Volumvine Yarns and the Yarngasm podcast's Box O' Socks Cal. But I gotta count them again and make sure. And I started a shawl this past weekend. I've been waiting to start this shawl. It's kind of my reward for finishing my sweater and my other shawl on time. I was gonna start it as soon as I finished the sweater, but then I had enough time to finish the descent shawl. So I started my Hocus Pocus three-color cashmere shawl. This is the three-color cashmere shawl by Hohi Locatelli. And you can see I'm started in the third color. Not the third color, but the third section in the directions for that first pattern section. I'm making no sense. Started with color A, which is Legacy Fiber Arts Steely Toes Winnie Sanderson. This is color B, Legacy Fiber Arts Steely Toes Spellbook. And then color C, which looks like it's just one stripe of color, is going to be Legacy Fiber Arts Sparkle Toes in Mary Sanderson. What else? I'm knitting this on a US 4, 3.5 millimeter needles. The pattern calls for a 6, and usually for shawls and things, 2 needles down gets me the same gauge as somebody who knits with a size 6. So I have a very loose gauge. It's a baby shawl right now, but I'm very excited about it. And I started it while watching Hocus Pocus with Gabby the other day while she was over for Rhinebeck shenanigans. Good times. So we'll just quickly go over some fiber stuff. It's so sad that Sith and Spin is over. The only fiber I've been working on is my never-ending mystery fleece. Here's a spool of it, a bobbin of it. It's been a while since I talked about it, so let me give you a brief rundown of my mystery fleece. Last year, about a year ago, I bought a feed bag full of sheep fleece from a local farmer down the road for dirt cheap, $10 for this huge bag of fleece. There were at least two fleeces in there. I don't know if pieces of another fleece got in there, but there's at least two whole fleeces. And she doesn't know what the breed of sheep is, because the sheep were originally owned by somebody who one of her friends knew, who unfortunately passed away, and she offered to take their orphan sheep, and there was no records or anything about what kind of sheep they were, so she doesn't know what they are. The fleece is not sheared professionally. The sheep is not necessarily bred for spinning fiber, and I picked a fresh one that she had cut that year, but it was not stored well in her barn for, to keep things out. So it's really not great quality fleece. I mean, it could be if, if there were some things that she could have done, but it was $10 for all this fleece, and it's a good learning tool for me. But I have so much of it left. I have so much of it. I've spun one fleece. I have a lot of sheep fleece up there, and I haven't even carded it all because I don't have space for all the carded bats. Unless I seriously card it all in one sitting and then can put them back in the container where the locks are right now. So it is my goal this winter to finish carding and spinning the rest of this mystery fleece. So that next year I can buy a spinning fleece at a fiber festival or something. That's the goal. So there's going to be a lot of this in this section in the future. I won't show it every episode because just seeing this over and over again is going to be really boring. And I do have other things, in process / in the queue for drop spindling, so I might be able to show you some of that. But for now, because Christmas present knitting is already underway, and I'm mostly going through this, there's not going to be that much other spinning for a while. And that brings us to sewing stuff. Like I said, I can't show you Halloween costume stuff just yet, but I also worked on my Halloween quilt. I'll throw up some pictures here of the full quilt top that I finished sewing together, and the quilt back that I sewed together, because I can't hold it up and show you the whole thing, especially now that it's in a hoop. So let me pull this up real quick. So now that you've seen what they look like in full, here's what it looks like in a hoop. It is very cumbersome. Started hand stitching the quilting, which you won't be able to see on this camera at all. I've gone from here to here through the ditch, which is the seam on the quilt top. And I've started here, and I'm going up straight here. So I'm going to quilt this in just parallel lines. I think these are going horizontally, but I can't tell because it's in a hoop right now. But horizontally, or parallel, through the main ditch seams here, and then up these two 9-patch seams And then I'm going to go halfway through those seams. So I'll have a whole bunch of parallel lines all together. And this will take forever. This quilt probably will not be finished at the earliest next Halloween. But it's interesting and just kind of nice, mindless, especially since I've got this bit of yarn here as like a ruler to kind of guide where my straight line should be. You probably won't see very much of this in the coming months either, because it will look like nothing for a while. And it's so big that I have to put it in my collapsible laundry basket that I originally bought to hold bags of works in progress, because it's too big for any project bags or tote bags that I own. It's not a massive quilt, but it's a massive bundle of fabric. Filming got interrupted by dinner in the middle there, so no more shawl, and now I'm not quite sure where we are. I talked about fiber stuff, and I believe I said everything I wanted to say about the Halloween quilt. So that will bring us to new stuff, and my voice is doing funny things, so let's ignore it for a second. Let's start with pre-Rhinebeck things. I received this cube bag from Zigzag Stitches in the mail on Thursday. The card that came with it, which was just a thank you from the seller, made it seem like this was purchased, but I didn't purchase it. And I don't believe anybody told me that they were going to purchase me this thing. So if you bought this for me, let me know who you are so I can say thank you. Because this is a wonderful little bag and actually came at just the right time, because I had just finished piecing together my Halloween quilt, and it's the perfect size for my hand quilting things, like this needle book and my curved safety pins and my thread and my little pair of scissors and all that stuff. Wow, where's my voice going? Hopefully, wow, it's, I don't know what's going on. I think I'm losing my voice now. Yeah, so this is a lovely little bag, and I'd like to thank whoever sent it to me, so let me know if it was you so I can thank you. And then I got two skeins of yarn before Rhinebeck. The first skein I got is the first mystery skein from Gabby from Once Upon a Corgi's Lemony Snicket series of unfortunate events skeins of yarn. These are up for pre-order for the first 5 days of the month, and then you get a mystery colorway based on one of the series of unfortunate event books. So the first mystery colorway is out now. This is from the first book, The Bad Beginning, and if you haven't received yours yet, because I get them as soon as she puts them in my hands, and yours might still be in the mail, turn away now! I won't describe the colors to you. So, you know, mute this, go away. Do whatever you need to do if you don't want to know what this color is, because you're waiting to get yours. Are they gone? I think they're gone. So, this is the first colorway. It is called Briny Beach. My voice is doing so many weird things right now. Anyway. It's beautiful, and you can see there's these little tags in the skein. One says left and one says right, and if you hold them per the directions, and you might need to shift the yarn a little bit, Gabby did something really cool with the dye in this skein that fans of a series of unfortunate events will really get a kick out of. I won't tell you the secret, but it's awesome. And that skein is put away now, so if you left for the spoilers. It's fine. I'm waving my hands around so you can get a good clicking back here point. So I got one more skein of yarn before Rhinebeck, and that is from Junk Yarn, which is a yarn line by Kemper of the Junk Yarn podcast. And it's exactly which colorway you think it is. It's the Rey colorway, because everything is Star Wars, and it's beautiful. Look at those speckles. It's amazing. Don't know what it's going to grow up to be, but it's amazing. The skein is in her smooth sock, which is 75% superwash merino and 25% nylon. Oh, I forgot to say that the skein from Gabby's in the Audrey base, the 80-20 BFL nylon, because that's kind of my go-to base of hers for fingering weight yarn. But this is amazing, and I'm very excited that she's doing these like occasional pre-orders, because it's impossible to get her stuff. For me, it is literally impossible unless I want to sit in the Walmart parking lot for a half hour in order to buy it, because her shop updates are at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and I'm driving home then. I'm usually just around the corner from my house, but I can't buy yarn if I'm driving the car. So, that's hard. But these pre-orders were really nice, and I really appreciate being able to pre-order a skein. I love it. So now it is time for the Rhinebeck haul. I bought no yarn. Not a single skein at Rhinebeck. Not a one. I do have some stuff to show you though. First, let me start with these little goodies. At the podcaster meetup, there were a couple of people giving out little things. I got a couple of pins, which are all on the bulletin board now because I finished the podcast the first time trying to film this podcast yesterday, so I started putting things away, and I'm not going to go pull them off the board now. But I did get some pins from Connie of Chile Knits, one from Sue, because she had a handful of buttons, and I was like, gimme. Who else did I get a button? From the Yarn Hoarder, whose podcast I have to go check out, and I believe that was the lady who we had met at Stitches Midwest, but she didn't have a podcast at the time, and she didn't know that we had podcasts at the time, so when we met her again, it was like, oh, it's you! It was very exciting, if I'm remembering the correct person. Sorry if I'm not. Helen and Mary Beth Graham from Toad Hollow made these little pyramid bags to hand out to some people, and they gave me one, and it was full of snacks, and I've eaten half of them, and the other half are in my candy bowl in front of the TV. But here, let's show you that right side up. Here is their card, their information that I will also include in the show notes. Bring this back slowly so that the camera refocuses on me. And this is lovely, and it was very exciting to receive it. I don't know what I'll put in here quite yet, but it's very exciting, and I'm excited about it, and it's Halloweeny. And I got another little thing from a newer podcaster. This is from Barbara. I'm terrible with names. It says it on the card, so I'm just reading. Barbara from the Flame and Fiber podcast. Hopefully you can read that, and if not, I'll put the information in the show notes. Who has a new podcast. I think she put out her fifth episode today. And she's called the Flame and Fiber podcast because she does glass work. And so she made these little glass... Stop doing things. Glass Progress Keeper stitch marker thingies. I can't tell if that's in focus. or if the background is in focus. But it's really cool that you made these things and gave them out. So thank you for that. It was very lovely to meet you. And then I did spend some money. No yarn, just fiber. Which is kind of how I planned it. Because we had Stitches Midwest in the middle of the year and I knew that was going to be a yarn fest, I purposefully did not buy fiber for most of this year. Like, the very beginning of the year I bought fiber. For my birthday I bought fiber, and at Connecticut Sheep and Wool in April I bought fiber, and then I bought no fiber for the rest of the year. Pretty sure. Or if I did, it was from Classy Squid Fiber Company because I was spinning it right then. Right that minute. So I didn't buy any fiber on the Yarn Crawl or at Stitches Midwest or at the Coventry Farmers Market. So fiber was what I wanted at Rhinebeck. So the first place we went was to the loop booth to get a loop bump. If you saw the Instagram post, you saw that I made the comment that I don't quite have goth phases so much as I have Sith aesthetic phases, which is kind of true. I do have goth phases, but they coincide so strongly with my Star Wars obsession that it's somewhere between goth and Sith aesthetic. For real. So that's this loop bump. They call this colorway Cherry Pit. It's 5.1 ounces of Merino, Tussa Silk, and Angelina. I'm very excited to spin this when I finish my mystery fleece, which will be forever from now, but these will be lovely treats at the end. And then I bought two braids from Into the World. I bought one on Saturday because the colorway looked like it was getting sold very quickly, and then I went back on Sunday and got another one. So the first one I got was this braid of Polworth in the colorway Quoth the Raven. And that's beautiful. And then on Sunday I bought this braid of English Shetland called Ravenswood. And they kind of go together. I'm gonna let these sit next to each other for a while and see how I like them. And they might get plied together, because the texture of these two wools and the way they're prepared is actually very similar. So it would not be like a weird feeling yarn if I plied them together. But I think I have to unbraid them and let them co-mingle before I make a final decision. But we'll see. But they're both lovely and I'm so excited about it. I also bought a whole bunch of locks. Because locks are super fun now that I know what I'm doing with them, more or less. There was this booth there by Naaman Angoras. I hope I'm saying that right. Naaman? I might not be saying that right, but that's their information. And I bought a whole bunch of mohair locks. They had one of those setups where they have just bins of different colored dyed locks and then a bunch of undyed locks. And you grab a plastic bag and you fill up however much you want and they weigh it and you pay the amount. It was $6 an ounce, which is pretty good. So I got a whole bunch of locks. I got these gray locks and black locks. And these will be part of the collection of locks that I'm aiming to get to spin tailspun yarn for a cloak mantle, like a ridiculous person. But I figure I'll buy gray and black and like natural gray brown locks from a bunch of different sources, so then I can jumble them all up and spin them together, and it will be really interesting. And then I got a whole bunch of locks for textured bat making, because I really want to get into textured bats once I have some freedom with the drum carter. They had these color blend dyed locks, so this one's a teal, a green, and a very light green. And that's lovely. These are my Slytherin locks, because that's the most Slytherin thing that you've ever seen in your life. I can guarantee it. Look at it. Oops. Like, look at how perfectly Slytherin these are. Nope, it's not going to focus on it. Whatever. Oh, they're so soft and wonderful. And I got this color blend, which is a black, a brown, and a gold, which is really, really striking. Look at how beautiful those are. Don't you just want to, like, lie in a bed of these? They're so wonderful. And then I got some kind of pops of color locks. I found when I was playing with locks and doing the Darth Venge bats that just having a few really bright colored locks in there for pops of color was really cool. So I got a yellow handful, I got a pumpkin-y handful, and I got a chartreuse handful. These won't necessarily go together in the same bat or whatever, but I figured I'd get some really bright colored ones to, as kind of accent fibers. And that was all the locks I bought from them. And then I bought a bag of miscellaneous dyed Cotswold locks from Solitude Wool. These were the people that I bought mixed dyed locks from last year that I've really enjoyed playing with, so I figured I'd pick up some more of them. It's wonderful. So that wasn't out of control at all, which I'm very proud of myself for. That's a reasonable amount of fiber to come home with from a fiber festival. So good job me. And real quick, we'll just go through some other stuff. Because I was on vacation, there's a lot of stuff that I'm watching. I watched through Stranger Things on Netflix. I watched through Jonathan Strange and Mr. Norrell on Netflix. I've nearly finished Penny Dreadful on Netflix. I'm in the second episode of the third season. So, nearly done there. And all my superhero shows are back on TV, so Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., Supergirl, Flash, Arrow, and DC Legends of Tomorrow. I'm all watching. Was that it? I think so. Still not caught up on video podcasts, but I'm working on it. I'm back in kind of a podcast groove, so hopefully I'll be able to catch up more or less on all those podcasts again soon. Stuff I'm reading. I started re-listening to Star Wars audiobooks. I was in the process of listening to Darth Plagueis for the first time, but it's kind of a slow book. And it's not that it's not interesting, but I came off of listening to all these kind of Sith adventure stories, and Darth Plagueis is not an adventure Sith. He's a creepy library, lure you to your doom Sith, and I just wanted some adventure Star Wars. So I started re-listening to Star Wars The Old Republic Fatal Alliance by Sean Williams and narrated by Mark Thompson. I re-listened to Star Wars The Old Republic Deceived by Paul S. Kemp, which I believe is also narrated by Mike Thompson. And Gabby and I listened to a chunk of Star Wars Clone Wars Gambit Stealth for the drive to and from Rhinebeck on Saturday, because we wanted just something to put on and kind of half listen to. And I have the next book in the series for that one, so I wanted to listen to it again before I start Star Wars Clone Wars Gambit Siege. They're up there now. That's very sad. I did finish two Galaxy of Fear series books. I finished... Oh, I forgot the name of the book now. The first one with the planet that eats you. I'll put the title somewhere. And City of the Dead, which is the second one, and sounds exactly like what you think would happen. I'm now reading Plague Planet, but they haven't even landed on the planet yet, so... Yeah, it's been... I just haven't been in a reading mood, except for fanfic, because I'm always in a fanfic reading mood. Yeah, I've been more of a writing mood. It's hard to read and write at the same time for me. I'm either in one brain space or the other, sometimes. Which brings me to the fanfic recommendation for this episode, and I'm going to recommend the fic Turn My Sorrow into Treasured Gold by Cosmic Ocean. This is a post-prequel fic in an alternate universe where Padme does not die. She lives, and Obi-Wan goes with her to raise her children in secret while they start the Rebel Alliance. And it's kind of half adventure, half slice of life fic. So you get, you know, Padme and Obi-Wan thwarting the Empire, but also them raising Luke and Leia. And there is a bit of a romance that develops between them later, after they've spent a number of years together raising Luke and Leia. It's really nice fic. I really enjoy it. Sometimes you just need a little bit of nice fic. And there's some really good character development for Padme in this fic. You get more of a bridge between... Or you see more of the Padme that we got to know in Attack of the Clones and the Clone Wars TV show than we do the Padme that ultimately ended up being in Revenge of the Sith, because that was a real shame that her character was kind of devolved into this one-note thing at the end there. It really kind of sucked that that's what happened, because she was really dynamic and interesting before. But yeah, that's my recommendation for this week, and I don't really have anything else to say other than thank you for watching, and if you're watching this for the first time because you met me, hello. And it was nice to see all of you at Rhinebeck. I'm gonna end it here so I can go see whether or not this actually worked this time around. If you're watching this, it did, so cross your fingers in retrospect, and I don't know what that means. Let's ignore my ramblings for a while. So that's going to be it. Show notes and links to everything will be over at my website at freakishlemon.com. Come join the Ravelry group. Just search Freakish Lemon in the groups tab. You can follow me as Freakish Lemon at all the fun places like Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, Ravelry. There's still some stuff up in the Etsy store, I believe, but I have to do some listing management. So, you know, if you really want to see what's for real available, just, you know, poke me somewhere, shoot me a message, and just yell at me saying, hey, are these all the listings? And make me actually deal with them. because I'm terrible at remembering to do little things like renewing listings, but I don't want them to auto-renew until the end of time, you know? Whatever. I gotta rework the shop, for real. Links to everything will be in the down bar here on YouTube or somewhere around here if you're watching this somewhere else. And please remember to subscribe. Click that little subscribe button if you would like to know when I upload episodes or little mini-sodes or whatever else that's going to be put up in this channel. So that is going to be it. I really hope this worked this time. Goodbye.